Good morning, Rutgers. I'm Maciel Torres.
And I'm Kim Ballard. We've got a great show lined up for you. It is Thursday, October 13th, 2016.
Today, we're going to paint the town scarlet with Morgan Tiani at Yoga for Everyone. Doesn't that look fun?
That looks so much fun. Maciel and I will give you the regional forecasts for the day.
And I'm going to chat with Siobhan Gibbons from CAPS about how to de-stress during midterms, which I think we all need.
I definitely think this week would be great for that. And Chloe Cooper is going to tell you all about Frozen playing on our channels this month.
Let's start the show. You're watching Wake Up Rutgers on RUTV.
Hello, Rutgers. It's great to be here on this foggy slash chilly Thursday morning.
Yeah, we're here to wake you up every Thursday morning with all of the exciting news, events, and weather happening on campus.
Oh, yeah. So I heard midterms are happening
for a lot
of people.
Yeah, that's a thing right now. You know, midterm exams are here, and there's plenty of ways to de-stress. How do you de-stress, Kim?
How do I de-stress? I do a lot of acting and theater things, and
yeah.
That kind of helps get my mind off of everything that's going on academically. And I'm a theater major too, though, so it's kind of combined. So do I really de-stress?
Probably not.
Sometimes I paint, though.
Oh, that's good. I used to paint. I have to get back to that. I used to paint.
Well, what do you do to de-stress?
I usually just take a long shower, put some music on, or I read a good book. Currently reading, what am I reading right now? What is that called? Gabriel Garcia Marquez, Love in the Time of the Cholera? I don't know the English translation, but that book, it's really good.
It's really good. And it's written in Spanish?
Yeah. Spanish and English.
Okay.
But it's a good book. But one thing I've been meaning to try is yoga. I tried it once, and I was so tired that I passed out.
You know, my friend keeps telling me to come to yoga with her on Saturday mornings on Douglas, and I just need to make time. It's like my only time to like kind of sleep in. So I'm like, do I do yoga? Do I sacrifice that?
You can nap during yoga.
I'm
sure it's not supposed to work that way, but.
But you can do it.
Well, one thing we can do is take a look at Paint the Town Scarlet event, which was yoga for everyone like us. Let's take a look.
Good morning, Rutgers. I'm Morgan Tiani, and today I'm here at Yoga for Everyone, an event being hosted by the Rutgers Summer Sessions. This class is a fun, relaxing way to improve your circulation, flexibility, and overall health. So why don't we go do some yoga? Tell us a little bit about Yoga for Everyone.
Yeah, so yoga is really old. It's about 5,000 years old, so it comes from India. What we do here typically falls under this very large umbrella of Hatha yoga.
Awesome. Who do you think can benefit from doing yoga?
Everyone. And that's not even, you know, oh, that's a blanket term. Literally everyone, anyone and everyone, from, you know, young kids to 90-year-old individuals. My job is to be the guide. I facilitate the students' practice, and I'm here to help and make sure that they come out on the other end okay.
So what brought you out to Yoga for Everyone today?
Today I came out to yoga because my friend texted me and told me about it, and then I just signed up for a Flex Pass, so I want to try it and see if I liked it anyway.
It was free and outside.
So on a scale of 1 to 10, what would you say your current level of stress is?
Maybe like 10 being the highest, like a 3.
Stress is about 3.
3?
and I just had a calc exam today, so it brought it down.
And what do you enjoy most about this class?
I love that it was outside. I love that, you know, you get to see the trees and everything. I like the music. What else do I like about the class? I like that we were outside today.
We're here with our drummer. What's your favorite part about doing the yoga classes?
It's just nice, you know, it's different. I can kind of do whatever I want, and I just like supporting movement a lot, and yoga is kind of movement. It's also very spiritual, so it's a nice vibe, and it's just a nice gig to have as a musician.
Can you tell us what your favorite yoga pose is?
That's really hard. The first one that comes to mind, though, is Wild Thing. It's a hip opener, but it's sort of upside downy type. It looks way harder than it is.
I like the pigeon pose and the tree.
Ooh, the tree. You just hang out there up there. Well, that's awesome.
Probably tree.
Favorite yoga pose.
Downward facing dog.
Honestly, my downward dog is struggling right now. So I would say upward swan.
Well, Ruckers, that's all the relaxation for today here at Yoga for Everyone. Until next time, keep painting the town scarlet. I'm Morgan Ciani, RUTV.
Well, it's about time to take our first break, but before we go, let's see how much you know.
What are the most common mental illnesses college students struggle with?
Well, we'll find out the answer right after this.
I don't know, man. I don't know if I can run today. I'm really busy and, wait, what? You're running there? I did not know this. I didn't even know that was a place.
Do you know all the places on campus where you can work out and exercise? Well, we do, and we want to share that with you. Werblin Recreation Center is located on Bush Campus on the corner of Frelinghuysen and Bartholomew Road. Werblin has everything from badminton courts to an Olympic-sized swimming pool. The Livingston Recreation Center is located on Road 3 off of Joyce Kilmer Avenue. This center has a full weight room, hosts many different classes, and even has a spa located right inside to help you relax after a tough workout or maybe just a tough exam. The Cook Douglas Recreation Center is located on Beale Road across from the Cook Student Center. This recreation building comes equipped with a fun fitness center, pool, and racquetball courts for those of you who like sports with a little danger. The College Avenue Gym is located directly on College Avenue, right next to the Student Center. This location has multiple gyms and basketball courts, power and conditioning rooms, and is the only location with a rock wall. The Rutgers Fitness Center is located on Easton Avenue on the College Avenue campus. This is the only location that is just a fitness center. So this might be the place for people looking to just work with weights and machines. Rutgers also has multiple bike and walking paths that run throughout all the campuses. You can find a map of all the paths at ru.rutgers.edu/bikewalk. Most facilities are open Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. until 11:30 p.m. Weekend hours vary, but you can find out more information about the facilities and their hours at recreation.rutgers.edu.
Welcome back, Rutgers. Before the break, we asked, what are the most common mental illnesses college students struggle with?
And it's time to find out the answer. So according to the National Alliance on Mental Health, college students struggle with depression, anxiety, eating disorders, addiction, and suicide. That's very sad, but thankfully, you know, at least Rutgers has a lot of great resources for students dealing with those kind of issues.
Absolutely. I've been to CAPS before to deal with some personal issues of my own, and I think it's a great resource for students to have.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Yeah, I think it is a great resource, and it's great that these things are spoken about more. So now we know it's an issue and we can do something about it.
That's definitely part of the problem for a long time, I think, when there's the stigma around mental illnesses, mm-hmm. people people think it's kind of bad and they don't talk about it, and that doesn't help anybody. So it's really great that it's becoming less stigmatized and people can get the help they need.
I actually had my first panic attack this summer, and it was the scariest thing of my life. I thought I was dying, and I ended up in the hospital overnight. But
it was just,
you know, I had a lot of things built up that I wasn't dealing with.
Yeah.
So if I would have had maybe someone to talk to or a way to de-stress, that could have been
avoided. At least a way to address it,
exactly.
For sure.
But in other news, let's take a look at the weather for the week. And we are off to a ghoulish start with the weather this morning. It is currently in the low 50s with a very dense fog. Be careful on your morning commute, as visibility is only a quarter mile. Later, the weather is expected to look up. The high will be 70 degrees with a sun, and it'll be sunny early on. From 3 to 6 p.m., there is a threat of showers. However, after 6, the clouds are expected to clear up.
And tomorrow will be a beautiful and sunny day. The temperatures will start off in the low 50s, but will be in the 60s by the end of the day. Early forecasts for the weekend are predicting wonderful fall weather as well. Saturday will be sunny and have a high of 65 degrees. Sunday will also be sunny with a high of 70 degrees. Make sure you take a break from your studying and enjoy the nice weather while you still can.
I was going to say that we need to take advantage because it's getting there.
It's getting there, but I'm so excited that the weather's going to be nice on Saturday because I'm going pumpkin picking.
You are?
Yay!
Where?
So I'm actually going up to my hometown with my boyfriend, and we're going to go pumpkin picking. It's going to be a great time. We're going to make some pumpkin-y foods.
Where's your hometown?
I live in North Jersey, New Jersey, so it's really kind of rural up there, and there's a bunch of pumpkin patches, so
that's
might as well enjoy that good weather while we can. Are you doing anything fun this weekend?
I was, but Drake canceled his concert, or postponed it, so that was my gift to my boyfriend for his 21st birthday, and
postponed it?
Yes,
what
so maybe I will go pumpkin pick. Yeah, he messed up his ankle or something, and now he's going to do that concert a little later, so.
Go pumpkin.
I'll go.
It's a good choice. It's a good choice. Well, we'll be right back after this with your news and events.
Welcome to Livingston Campus at Rutgers University. Located in Piscataway, Livingston is the youngest of New Brunswick and Piscataway's five campuses and is a place that anticipates the future. In the past 5 years, Livingston Campus has been revamped. In 2011, the campus opened up a new dining commons and renovated its student center by adding meeting and lounge rooms, dining options, and a convenience store. In 2012, the Livingston Apartments opened up, and below these beautiful residence halls is the Livingston Plaza that includes stores, restaurants, and a cinema. Fall of 2013, the new Rutgers Business School building opened up. It provides students with up-to-date tools and resources to successfully prepare for the business world. To find out more information about the Livingston campus, visit livingstoncampus.rutgers.edu.
So Kimberly, can you tell us a little bit more about what you're doing tonight?
Well, actually, I can. I'm going to be a part of the bed races for the first time ever, and I'm very excited.
Ooh, senior year is good to do these things.
Senior year, I went to it my freshman year, and I remember thinking, I got to do that one day. I want to drive the bed. I think it's going to be so much fun. So I'll tell you a little bit more about that. Assemble your team, decorate your bed, and get ready to race, because the 9th annual Homecoming Charity Bed Races are around the corner. Tonight. This event will take place today at 9 p.m. on College Avenue. As an entry fee, all participants are required to donate a minimum of 400 new diapers to benefit the Cuddle Me Diaper Bank of New Jersey. If you're not racing, come support your fellow Scarlet Knights and a great cause. For more information, visit rupa.rutgers.edu/bedraces.
You know, I love that because I've said it a few times on the show, since I grew up here, I don't really experience as much of as the Rutgers stuff that I, like, I didn't know that they existed. So maybe I'll drag my boyfriend and we can.
You should go.
We should go.
It's going to be so much fun.
He needs to see what all the cool things happening at Rutgers, so.
And people decorate their beds in such creative ways, and I'm so excited
about it. I'm excited to watch you. I'll let you know. I'll text you about it.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so do you want to harness your inner calmness and be able to reduce your stress levels? Is balancing schoolwork and personal life stressing you out? Come join mindfulness meditation at the Douglas Student Center. Through meditation, this event works to help those reduce their stress levels and to initiate calmness from within. The event will take place from 12 to 1 p.m. today, and all are welcome. There's no registration, equipment, or fee required. For more information, you can visit rhscaps.rutgers.edu/mindfulness-meditation.
So have you ever meditated before? Is it something that you've tried?
I actually have tried it once. It was in my basement, like with a pair of headphones on, some online creepy program trying to like do some hypnosis. I don't know, I was a strange child, but.
No, I've done that.
It was weird.
I've done that so many times.
Did it work for you?
It's harder for me to do it alone because I find myself wanting to do other things, but I think it's good to do it in a group setting like this mm-hmm. because other people around you will kind of not force you, but kind of convince you to like, okay, now we need to be a part of this. We need to all meditate together. Because if everybody else is doing it, then you're more likely to do it
exactly.
and not get distracted.
And doing it alone in your basement, like I tried to do it, was a little scary.
It's a little
like,
scary.
What if I can't get out of it?
Yeah.
You know? No one's going to hear me scream.
Oh my gosh, that's hilarious.
But let's talk about the weather a little more.
Yeah, so according to a paper published by scientists at Rutgers University, Princeton University, and the Woods Hole Oceanographic Institute, New York City is likely to expect 9-foot floods at least 3 times more frequently over the course of the next century. Based on a combination of historical data and computer model projections, scientists can determine future sea level models and storm intensity, as well as work on historical sea level and surges. The primary cause has largely to do with the natural effects and the human-caused climate change over the late 20th century, which has dominated sea level rise. Benjamin Horton, a professor of marine and coastal sciences in the School of Environmental and Biological Sciences, says if nothing changes with hurricanes, sea level rise alone will increase the frequency of Sandy-like events by 2100. Princeton University's Ning Lin was able to integrate historical climate data and future climate conditions, which projected a more modest 3-fold increase in flood probability, making Superstorm Sandy's flood 17 times more probable. Robert Kopp, a professor of Earth and Planetary Sciences in the School of Arts and Sciences, estimates sea level rises over the 21st century and how various factors cause local sea level to vary from global sea level. While these are projections and not predictions, Horton says it will only get worse by 2100. It is just a question of how much worse it will get. For more information on this fascinating study, visit news.rutgers.edu. I think it's clear that we need to make some changes in the way that this country works if we want to help reduce our global footprint.
Yeah, and I think that, unfortunately, that's also part of our culture, just, you know, driving everywhere.
Yeah.
And not so much physical activity. Because I've been to other countries and people walk everywhere.
Yeah.
Literally everywhere.
It's very hard in this country because I think things are so spaced out.
Yeah.
The weather, it's a lot of issues. But
I'm not going to lie, I drive to unnecessarily close places. Like
I think we all do. It's just ingrained in our culture.
Yeah.
That's
unfortunate. We need to change that because it said 20-foot floods or 9-foot floods.
Yeah.
That would literally kill me. I'm
That's catastrophic.
6 foot.
I mean, we saw how bad Sandy
yeah.
was just a few short years ago. So that's unfortunate. We need to try to change that in our culture.
Another thing in our culture that is up for some debate is selfie culture. So Vincent Van Gogh's portraits of himself are considered one of the predecessors of the modern selfie, said Rutgers professors Mary Chaco, whose Burn seminar, Selfies and the Digital Culture, explores the cultural significance of how selfies were taken then and now. Isn't that crazy? There's a whole seminar dedicated to that?
That is wild. I think, you know, I feel like selfie culture gets a bad rap. And I mm-hmm. feel like selfies are not necessarily as bad as people like to make them out to be. I think if people take a selfie, like, more power to them. They're feeling good about themselves that day. Take a selfie. I don't think it's that big of a deal. But I know a lot of people get you know, they kind of get made fun of for taking selfies, especially
yeah.
in our generation. But I think it's a fine thing. I don't think there's anything wrong
Not
with
only
it.
Not only that, you learn so much about, and this was also part of the story, that you learn so much about a person and what they care about and the culture of society at that time by what they photograph.
Yeah.
So it's not so narcissistic. It's more, you know, it's more just a cultural thing.
That's what I think. And also, it's like, if you feel good about yourself, take that selfie. Be proud. Like, I don't see it as a problem. People like to call it narcissistic. I completely disagree. I think in a society that tells women that they shouldn't like themselves for a lot of reasons, mm-hmm. like, take your selfie.
Very
Be proud
true.
Of the way you look. That's what I think.
So, guys, we're going to take a quick break, and then I will tell you more about selfie culture when we get back.
Attention Rutgers students. Are you tired of waiting in long lines for your refund check? Students are highly encouraged to sign up for electronic deposit with RU Scholar Refund for the fastest, safest, and most convenient way to receive refunds. Log in with your Net ID and a valid Rutgers email address at finservices.rutgers.edu/OTB. Funds are available for immediate use. All students enrolled in RU Scholar Refund by October 1st are entered to win one of five $75 gift cards. Learn more at studentabc.rutgers.edu/electronic refunds.
Do you like kicking back in your free time? Sometimes the dorms can get stuffy and boring, so head on over to the Rutgers Zone. Need somewhere to watch sports? Need to satisfy that ice cream craving? Or are you tired of your old video games? Rutgers Zone is where you need to visit. Enjoy some games, food, TV, karaoke, and so much more. And don't forget to ask for those ice cream toppings. With all of the cool things at the Rutgers Zone, why would you even leave? If you are on Livingston campus, make sure you swing by the Rutgers Zone, just a bus stop away. For more information, please visit zone.rutgers.edu.
Welcome back, Rutgers. I'm here with Siobhan Gibbons, and she is a
staff psychologist at CAPS.
I've been trying to get that right, but I knew I was going to mess it up, so I just didn't want to do it. All right, so what services can you tell us CAPS offers, and what else can you tell us about CAPS?
So we provide group counseling and short-term goal-oriented individual counseling, crisis counseling, medication management, and lots of workshops mm-hmm. for Rutgers graduate and undergraduate students. And if you want to make an appointment at CAPS, you can call the CAPS number, mm-hmm. or you can stop in at 17 Senior Street on the College Avenue campus.
And what are the hours that you can stop in by?
8:30 to 4:30.
Every day, Monday through Friday?
Monday to Friday.
Perfect.
Yes, not on the weekends.
Of course, everyone needs some time off, and that's part of being stressed and you know, being able to meditate. And we all know that college can get stressful mm-hmm. around this time of year. Mm-hmm. We have midterms and just personal things. Mm-hmm. How can we de-stress? What advice can you give us?
Well, I think, college students obviously are using their brain and their mind all the time. And I think one really important strategy is to find a way to rest your mind. Mm-hmm. Now, there's lots of ways to do this, and students already have lots of various ways to do this. But one really great way of resting the mind is through mindfulness meditation.
Okay, and what exactly is that?
So mindfulness is a skill that we can develop. It's a quality that we already have to some degree, this awareness. But what mindfulness is deliberately, intentionally developing this caring, compassionate, non-judgmental awareness of our own experience, of our thoughts, of our feelings, of our physical sensations. And then what meditation is are just exercises, drills that you do in order to develop the skill.
Okay, and can you talk a little bit more about how it is actually practiced? Is it in a room full of 10, 20 people?
You can. The fantastic thing about mindfulness meditation is that you can do it anytime, anywhere. You need absolutely nothing to do it. You don't need any special equipment. You don't need to be any special place. You can do it. What it is just drawing your attention towards yourself in a kind and caring way, to what's happening with yourself right at this moment, in a caring, compassionate way.
I feel like in our society we're so busy with things going on that we don't stop to think about how do I feel, what's going on in my life.
Exactly. You know? What's going on with me right at this moment?
I think I mentioned it a little earlier in the show. I had a panic attack this summer, and it was because of that.
Mm-hmm.
I was so pushed everywhere that I didn't take time to really focus and to center myself.
Yes. And then that's one of the ways in which we can definitely use to center ourselves.
Okay. So do you guys have any of these events coming up?
Oh, we have these events all the time.
Oh, perfect.
I teach the mindfulness meditation noon workshops. We do them 3 times a week. Tuesdays at noon at the Bush Campus Center. Wednesdays at the Student Activity Center, again at noon. And that's on the College Avenue campus. And then Thursdays at the Douglas Campus Center, and again at noon. And these are all drop-in workshops. I mean, these are not, you're not making any commitment to it. It's a way to check it out. They're free, there's no registration, you don't have to tell me you're coming.
Just come whenever you feel like you need it.
Exactly. And just come to just check it out. Just come if you feel like it, and if you don't, that's fine too.
Well, I think with this all this information, we kind of want to check it out. I don't see why not.
Yeah.
Dr. Siobhan Gibbons, thank you so much for being with us.
You're welcome. We're going to
come back right after this break.
The Rutgers University Infectious Disease Practice is a health clinic that provides medical care, treatment, and services to over 1,400 HIV-infected individuals. They serve the city of Newark and its surrounding communities where there is a high incidence of poverty, hunger, substance abuse, and mental health issues. Due to limited funding, the clinic is seeking donations in order to keep supporting patients' educational, psychosocial support, and celebratory activities. For more information, watch the video posted on the Rutgers Foundation website, which describes the clinic and highlights their committed staff. You can make a donation at the Rutgers University Foundation at one.rutgers.edu.
Welcome back, guys. And as you saw that interview, I thought that went
really. That was a really great interview.
And she's so calm.
She
is my life goals right there. Like, I'm such an angsty person.
She's practicing mindfulness.
Exactly.
I think that's important to keep yourself centered and calm. But now we're going to check out Frozen with Chloe Cooper.
Not the Disney one. Just check it out. Welcome back to another episode of What's on RUTV. I'm your host, Chloe Cooper, and I'm here to let you know about all the great movies we have playing on RUTV this month. How would you react if you were stranded on a ski lift in the bitter cold and no one was able to rescue you for at least 5 days? What would you do to survive? Unfortunately, for a group of 3 friends, this nightmare became a reality. Let's check out Frozen. Dan, Joe, and Parker decide to spend their Sunday at a New England ski resort. They really want to take one last run down the mountain before they leave, but the resort decided to close early before the impending storm hits. But they convince the ski attendant to let them go on one last time. Before the group gets all the way to the top, the attendant is called into his boss's office and is replaced by a coworker. As he leaves, he tells the coworker that there are only 3 skiers left. A different set of 3 skiers comes down the mountain, so when he sees them, he assumes there is no one left on the lift and shuts it down. Little does he know that those were not the 3 skiers he was told about, so Dan, Joe, and Parker become stranded in the middle of the airlift, far above the ground. At first, they think they're being punked, but soon after realize it's serious when the resort's lights are turned off. This leaves the 3 friends in fear and shock, as the resort is now closed for 5 whole days. They know that, at that rate, they will not survive, so they take matters into their own hands as they cook up a way to free themselves and come out the other end alive. Wow. After watching that, I'm scared for them, and I really hope they find a way to get help and make it out alive. You can watch Frozen on our channel 27.1. Students should also be aware that RUTV is participating in a one-year pilot program with HBO, Cinemax, and Encore to bring the newest and most popular movies to Rutgers students. If you're interested in seeing what's playing on HBO, tune in to channel 3.1. If you're interested in seeing what's playing on HBO 2, head to channel 3.2. And HBOS, tune in to channel 6.1. Cinemax is on channel 6.2 and Encore is on 8.1, while Encore C is on 8.2. For more information about all things playing on RUTV, head to rutv.rutgers.edu or follow us on Twitter and on Facebook. For What's on RUTV, I'm Chloe Cooper.
Well, Rutgers, that's it for today. Oh, I want to thank Dr. Siobhan Givens for being here and talking about mindfulness meditation.
Yes, thank you so much, Dr. Siobhan Givens. I'm Kim Ballard.
I'm Maciel Torres. We'll see you next week, Rutgers.